Life! Life can exist on Mars. Breakthrough alert right here. I'm Rebecca Felgate, and I'm bringing you some incredible news about life on Mars. Again, the urge to sing David Bowie is just so strong. So, our mate Mars, a shining red planet that is super cold and super barren. While we have found evidence of bacteria on Mars proving it was once capable of hosting life, we have never found any evidence that things could continue to live on our neighboring planet right now. Researchers from a university in the Netherlands carried out an experiment wherein they stimulate conditions of the red planet. Biologist Dr. Vigar Womlink was given soil from NASA. The soil actually comes from a Hawaiian volcano and is said to be extremely similar to soil substances on Mars. Dr. Vigar revealed that he had been able to grow rocket, or arugula to some of you guys watching. He was actually able to grow this plant in the soil. He then discovered worms living in the soil. Dr. Vigar said, "The best surprise came at the end of the experiment when we found two young worms living in the Mars soil stimulant." Worms, as you may or may not know, are vital for ecosystems and are key indicators of whether or not life can survive in an area. If worms are able to survive in stimulated Martian soil, they may also be able to survive on Mars itself, which is a vital step forwards towards colonizing the red planet. This may be necessary as Earth becomes overpopulated and climatically volatile in the future. While this may be a long way off, it does open up questions as to the possibility of farming on Mars. When it comes to our neighboring planet, further questions will be answered when our Mars rover missions begins in 2020. And further missions to the red planet that are set to take place over the next decade. To be honest, we've explored such a tiny amount of the planet, who knows what we'll find over there. Maybe there are indeed even Martian worms living their own lives in Martian soil, and that would be very exciting. I have to say though, this is a step in the right direction. Think about it, if we can get worms living in Martian soil right now, what will we get living over there in the next 100, 1000, 3000 years? Like, this soil is from a completely different place, but things from our place can live in it. It is amazing. So this is all I have on this topic for you, but before I go, I just want to leave you with some comments from Charlotte's video about why you shouldn't eat food that flies have landed on. Games have souls too. Wrote, "Your videos give me strength to work hard for my studies." Good, I'm glad to hear that. Strength. Learning is earning and knowledge is power, so have some more strength. Renee Games has it all figured out. They said, "Already knew this. My mum's always like, a fly landed on that, don't eat it. So that's why I don't wait before I eat, so I can keep my eyes on my food." I mean, I agree, don't wait. Get it in. So that is all I have for you now. Please do leave me a comment about life on Mars, and maybe even flood the comments section with alien emojis. You know it makes sense. Thank you guys for tuning into this episode of IO. I'm your host, Rebecca Felgate. If you like this video, make sure you give it a good thumbs up, share it with a friend, and stay subscribed for more news videos. If you want to keep overloading yourself with information, why not check out my video about an alien comet coming to play in our solar system, and also Charlotte's video about a barber who shaves eyeballs. Ew. See you next time.